Welcome to CrossLink. This is how you put a basic tax return in CrossLink. This is your work in progress screen. First thing you're going to do is hit Add New. It's going to ask you for the social. You're going to put it in exactly how the customer gives it to you. And you do not want to look at the top bar and type it in the second bar. Again, look at what the customer has handed you. You'll click OK. Next brings in the client data sheet. So you want to put in their birthday, their name, their occupation, this is asking if they're dependent of somebody else, if they're blind, if they're disabled, if they are, just put an X in the box. You want to get as many phone numbers for a person as you possibly can. The more phone numbers you have, the better it is. It's an invalid phone number, as you can see, it's loaded. You can put in their email address if you would like. A lot of people don't want to give it to you, but if you can, it's a good way to contact your client and send them reminders, especially if they have something that went on with the return, say it got rejected and you tried to call them. Sometimes you can get a hold of them by email. Gosh. You also have the option with CrossLink to do your text messages. If they would like a text message, like when their check arrives, you would put an X here, click Enter. Cell phone carrier, put a 3, and you pick the type of cell phone carrier they have, so they have AT&T. You would click on it, it's going to put it in there for you. So when something goes on with the return, you can notify them through text message, through CrossLink. Next, you're going to choose the filing status. If you watched the video prior to this, you should know the difference between single, the married, two married filing statuses, head of household, and qualifying widower. With this one, we are doing single. If you look at the bottom here, it tells you 1 for single, 2 for married filing joint, 3 for married filing separate, 4 for head of household, 5 for widower. We're doing single, so we'll do 1. When you hit enter, you notice it skips the spouse. You're going to put in an address. Once the address is in, it's going to ask you, is it APO, DPO, or FPO? A lot of times, this is military or people that live overseas. If they have this address, you would put the number that corresponds with it. If they don't, you just leave it blank. The next category is the bank. If they would like direct deposit, you can put their bank information in this area. You are always going to have to re-enter it to verify. If they were referred to you by somebody, you might want to put type of referral, say a friend referred them. You can hit F3, and it tells you. So that would be a client of yours, so you're going to put client, and say Jane Doe. And that's the highlight. There is a report you can put in CrossLink that will tell you who has been sending people to you. Next is dependents. Now he's a single guy, he don't have any dependents, so we're not going to worry about that. If you look over here on the left hand side under attached forms, you'll see the 1040s already in there, and the 8879, which is your e-file signature page. Now we need to add his income. He has handed me a W-2, so I'm going to click on Add Forms. All the forms you'll need for a tax return is in this area. I'm going to find the W-2, click on it, and it's going to bring up a W-2. You're going to enter it into the software just like the one they handed to you. So whatever is on the one they handed to you is on this one. You do not make corrections to a W-2. They say something is wrong with it, you send them back to the employer, and the employer will switch it. You're going to put in the employer identification number. You hit enter. It's ABC Incorporated. If you've used this company before or used this employer identification number before, it will autofill for you. If you haven't, you will put all the addresses. You can enter here, and it's going to take you to wages. This gentleman made $26,879. When I hit enter, it's going to put that number in 3 and 5 also. 1, 3, and 5 normally are the same, unless they had specific things withheld that weren't taxable, such as their retirement. Then 1 will be different than 3 and 5. If that's the case, you just click on the box that needs to be changed and change it. Remember, we're making an exact duplicate. Number 2 is federal tax withheld. He had $3,246 withheld. It already figured 4 and 6 for you because those are a set percentage for everyone. No matter what they made, it's the same percentage. So CrossLink goes ahead and figures that out for you. Well, if the W-2 is different, just click in the box and change it. It's not going to hurt anyone. Once you have their income in, you go back over here and click on the 1040. This brings up their actual tax return. You notice what's showing now is what we put in on the client data sheet. We put in his name, his social, and his filing status. When you go down, you'll see on number 7 has his income. And then keep scrolling down. Since he had no deductions, no dependents, it's the same thing all the way to line 38. We have his standard deduction taken out. His exemption amount taken out. And it leaves him with a taxable income of $17,529. You'll see that I'm removing the Schedule M. I have 2010 software on my computer, so in 2010, that was a deduction, but it is no longer a deduction, so I have removed it from this. So, this taxable income is $17,529. Where the software comes with this number is there's a tax table in the 1040 instructions. You look by his filing status and by the amount he makes, and it tells how much tax is due on this amount. His total tax is $2,210. So that carries down because he has no deductions, no credits, no anything. So line 60 is going to be $2,210. Line 61 has a number in it. Where'd that number come from? That's how much federal with income tax he had withheld from his pay. He had $3,246 withheld. That's going to come on down because he didn't have any other payments. If line 72 is larger than 60, they get a refund. That's wonderful. If line 60 is more than 72, then they owe. This is a very basic return, as I said before. To check for errors in the return, you're going to hit verify. At this point, most people would think they were done because they had the income in, everything's figured out. But you see that I had an error when I clicked verify. I'm going to double click on that and it's going to take me to the error. It's asking me, does this person want a check from the IRS, a direct deposit from the IRS, a RAL, which is a rapid anticipation loan from the bank? Do they owe a balance to the IRS, or do they want the refund, assisted refunds, what I call them, RACs, by the bank? For us, we do 1, 2, 4, and 5. No longer is there a 3. There's no rapid refunds. Our customers, most of them will be doing 5. That is where they don't have to pay us up anything up front. It is taken out of their check. So we're going to put a number 5 in here. So say he owes us $300 in tax credit fees. That's going to be subtracted from his check before he gets it. So we're going to hit enter. We're going to close this out. If you notice, that brings in the bank application. You'll want to always click on the bank application. There are certain things you have to do on it, and it won't go through unless you do it. You have to put the taxpayer's address again. If they're doing a state return, you're going to put yes that they want their state, just like they're getting their federal. You also have to answer the questions. Are they a member of the armed forces, or are they a dependent of the armed forces? Then you're going to have to put in their ID type. So say it's a driver's license. We're going to put in all the information from the driver's license. Once that's done, we're going to hit verify again. You'll see a lot of errors on mine. This is the fact I can't do a bank product because it's past years. But we can do some of these. So the first one, I'm going to click enter, and it's going to take me to the taxpayer's PIN. Software usually will auto-assign these in current years. But since it didn't, I'm going to put in the 5-digit PIN. It gives the signature date. These are things that we cannot change right now. That's fine. The things it's going to right now are things you really cannot change. Now when you get in live software, all of this will pretty much be done for you, so you won't have to do all this verifying. If you look, signature date must be within the processing year. Well, when you're doing a current return, yes, it will be in the processing year. Republic Bank ID code missing. Each bank has their own code. The bank app in live software will put the code in front for you. Let's see what this is. Prior tax information. We're going to put no. Another reply, allow text messaging. Let's put yes. And then print bank documents. That's a must. You must print and hand the people the bank documents and have them sign. You don't have to do it at the very first. So, for me, right now, I'm done. I've got everything done. That's all there is to a simple, single person with no W-2s, no credit, well, with W-2, no dependents, no credits, no deductions. You're just going to put the income in. You're going to verify the return, fix any errors, and we're done. On the fees, the best way to explain the fees is off the bank application. This shows all the fees. The bank fees, the taxpayer fees, the software fee. The total amount was this. So after you subtract all the fees, this is what's going to be paid directly to them. $464.09. For me right now, I'm going to take out the bank application. Let's see if it'll let me. Oh, it didn't do it. I'm going to go to the e-file. I'm going to make this a check from the IRS. I'm going to delete the bank application because I'm going to show you what it looks like when you verify it correctly. I'm going to change this date, 2010. I'm going to verify. I'm going to go 2010 and see if I have it. Let's try to verify. Now, all the errors are fixed. This is what you're going to see when all the errors are fixed. Let you know you have done a completed, simple return. Thank you.